Now to the cricket. The Australian and English cricketers are looking to the heavens, hoping that Britain's notorious summer doesn't thwart what's looming as a dramatic final day of the first Ashes test. Sam Jordan is covering the series. Sam, how are things looking in Birmingham?
Well, Peter, I know how it might look, but there is actually a feeling of optimism here at Edgbaston this morning. Ground staff are currently out in the middle of the field working on the pitch. The heavy covers are still on with rain throughout the night, but there is less than what was expected, which means there is raised hopes that we will receive cricket today even earlier than first thought. These showers are expected to clear. Close to lunch, we should be seeing play this afternoon. And because of the light here throughout the evening, they have extended play. So we are looking very likely to get a result to what has been an incredible test match here. The first test match of the Ashes series, which is very delicately poised. Australia need 174 runs to win today. And they have 7 wickets in hand after a dramatic final session that saw our big name bats, David Warner, Marnus Labuschagne and Steve Smith, all dismissed. However, it was Victorian hero Scott Boland who held his own at the crease as the night watchman. He will resume today on 13 runs alongside Usman Khawaja, and Australia very confident that they can pull off a famous test victory.
I'm backing our boys. I'm confident that our boys can go out there and bat well. And if we do the basics well, we give ourselves the best chance. But it's set up to be a thrilling test match.
So not long to wait, Peter. The thrilling finish of the first Ashes test will be here at Edgbaston in just a few hours' time. Australia hunting down a famous victory.
Just as long as the rain stops, I say. Thank you, Sam.